I was struck by the strangeness of the police reasoning. They came to this camp in Greece, and here it was people living in poverty, people not being able to access social services, an isolated group of people in a desperate situation. And the policeman only noticed the only thing wrong with that picture to him was that there was a blue-eyed Roma there.
Thank you for you know, raising that.
Is that the only thing he could see that was wrong?
Yeah, nobody's concerned about abject poverty. You know, many countries in Europe are quite different than what we have here in Canada in terms of our social safety net. You know, we have shelters for homeless people. Mm-hmm. Not enough, but we have some. Mm-hmm. Those things don't exist in other places. Mm-hmm. You know, for example, I'm going to give you an illustration of this. The Roma that have gone to France, you know, they've been placed in what are called integration camps, you know, and others have been forcibly removed from the country and sent back to places like Romania and Bulgaria. And, you know, the commissioner for human rights for the Council of Europe has said that they've not seen these sort of things taking place since, you know, World War II. Mm-hmm. And some of the same patterns are beginning to repeat itself in terms of the treatment of the Roma people. Mm-hmm. And why are more people not speaking out against this? Why is the European Union not doing a better job of addressing these issues? Why are we still talking about, you know, the issue of Roma inclusion rather than the issue of hate towards the Roma people, which is the real inhibitor for, you know, inclusion? So,
absolutely.
You know, the deeper root causes are never addressed when you have these million-dollar, billion-dollar, you know, initiatives focused around the inclusion of the Roma in Europe. Mm-hmm. You know, dealing with, you know, discrimination, dealing with multiculturalism, dealing with hatred and hatefully motivated crimes. You know, those are some of the beginning places that they should begin looking at. You can't include people when the others don't want them included.
Yes.
You know, and when the people that have been excluded for centuries in a country, you know, and persecuted, most notably, you know, the over a million people murdered from our community during the Holocaust. You know, people are fearful of society, and they need more reasons to trust.
Yes.
And become involved. So, yeah. You know, it's a two-way coin. Of course, the Roma have their work to do in including themselves in society, but there has to be meaningful and open routes to inclusion. There has to be the opportunity to participate in society. Yeah. You know, in places in Central and Eastern Europe, you have almost 100% unemployment rate. Mm-hmm. And is that because nobody in the community wants to work? Of course not. But of course, that's the stereotype that you'll hear.
Yes.
The Roma don't want to work. But you don't hear about...
Which becomes a reason not to give them a job if they ask for a job.
That's right. Why can't Roma have an opportunity to work?
Yeah.
You know? So, I mean, if you have this pervasive stereotype that every member of the 15 million population we have in Europe is a criminal, it's very difficult to get a job, very difficult to access school, housing, you know, or
and very difficult to avoid harassment and maltreatment.
Exactly.
Some of these things we read about in France, for example, really ugly incidents such as one of the ministers in the government saying these people are not like us. This is a socialist minister, by the way, in the French government. There was a case of a young woman who was taken off a bus during a school trip and by the authorities and deported from the country. What kind of echo of that do we have here? Is there some underlying issue with these countries that causes them so easily violate people's rights?
Well, you know, sadly, it often appears that the Roma people don't get to enjoy the same human rights as others.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the type of discrimination we face is endemic throughout Europe, especially in Central and Eastern Europe, where the largest Roma population lives. Many people don't realize that Roma people are the largest minority in Europe, totaling almost 15 million. And
15 million?
That's right, 15 mm-hmm. million. We're part of a very large diaspora beginning in the 11th century from northwestern India. We've been in Europe since about the 12th century. We were mistaken as Egyptians at that time, and we were labeled gypsies by English-speaking Europeans.
Mm-hmm.
And that name has stuck with us for centuries and has many negative connotations, as well as, you know, not not so bad stereotypes, but
By the way, some of the positive is almost a problem, right? In other words, there's a kind of romance of the Roma people by people like D.H. Lawrence having a title of a book. I think it was The Gypsy and the Virgin or something.
Those kind of things. And they're not always nearly as harmful as many of the more negative stereotypes that you have, you know, from people that have often imported their prejudice and hatred from Europe. And so those stereotypes sound more like, be careful, watch your wallet, you know, Roma / gypsies are thieves, be careful, they'll steal your children, and other things along those lines. And so you could see those stereotypes now, you know, playing themselves out in terms of the Roma family in Greece being immediately believed to have abducted a child because she had blonde hair and blue eyes, and they couldn't imagine that a Roma family would have such a light child.
Yeah.
So again, that guilty until proven innocent, but even when you're innocent, there's no apology that goes along with it, and the damage has been done. And this case was great in terms of highlighting the issues that we deal with in Europe and how pervasive and widespread they are. Mm-hmm. And of course, you know, we've had, you know, negative gypsy stereotypes exploited right here in Canada. You know, when our Canadian government leads the Canadian public to believe that Roma have come here to collect welfare or social services rather than escaping human rights abuse and persecution in Europe, that again is another example of, you know, fanning those gypsy stereotypes.
Gina, we're very grateful, and this is, to me, a vital issue, and I'm really glad you spoke to us today. We look forward to talking to you more in the future.